स्क्रीन खाली शेयर कर देंगे।
गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स, वार्म वेलकम ऑन दिस स्पेशल वेबिनार ऑन दी कोविड पैकेज डिक्लेयर बाय गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। वी हैव अवर गाइड टीसी वासना जी, वी हैव टुडे स्पीकर सी वेदांत के परीख। वी वेलकम यू ऑल, वी वेलकम ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स। वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट नाउ अवर गाइड सी टीसी वासना सर टू काइंडली इंट्रोड्यूस अवर टुडे स्पीकर सी वेदांत के परीख।
Thank you, Virat, for giving me an opportunity to warm welcome CA Vedant K. Parikh, who is a chartered accountant with certified FAST and having vast experience in audit, assurance, strategies, banking, and real estate industries, etc. He has been appointed as an independent director of Godhra City Cooperative Bank and was associated with the renowned CA firm Talati and Talati LLP, pioneered by the past president CA Sunil Talati, ICSA. Most welcome the Vedant K. Parikh on our this platform, and this Mr. Parikh will speak on this self-reliant packages of India of 20 lakhs crore and to the benefit of the business industries and real estate MSCB sectors, etc., etc., in details. So please welcome Vedant Parikh on their platform. Most welcome. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, Vapna ji. Now I would like to request Vedant bhai to start the session. Over to you, Vedant.
Okay. Thank you, Virat. I hope the screen is visible to everyone.
Yeah.
So I would like to start with a quote that it is when the horizon is the darkest and human reason is beaten down to the ground that faith shines brightest and comes to our rescue. A quote said by father of our nation, Mahatma Gandhiji, and recently quoted by our RBI governor in his speech when he was addressing the nation for this COVID package on May 22, 2020. This quote is very rightly said, and we can witness it implications around us. This year is considered to be the tragic year for the entire globe. Be it considered the spread of COVID-19 virus, burning of forests, storms, earthquake, etc. This year has changed the way of living of human beings. So, good evening, dear participants. Today we'll be discussing in brief. As we all know, the topic for the webinar is decoding the benefits of economic stimulus package, which has been announced by our Honorable Prime Minister. So the basic funda and the coverage of the topic will be in four parts. First being the economic stimulus package, which has been announced by our Honorable Prime Minister. Does the package offer as much as it is seen from a humongous amount of rupees 20 lakh crore? So that will be the question for all of us. Secondly, the benefits of the package to the public at large and to the professionals, of course. Thirdly, how do we move ahead in this scenario where government has shifted the lockdown to unlock one? So apart from that, we'll also be trying to cover some of the important updates which we should be aware as a professional and which in turn will be helpful in delivering services in a better manner. Well, if we see the support from the government in the form of relief or relaxation that has been received in a two phase. First being relief in the form of various relaxations in statutory and compliances norms, which we have discussed and considered in our previous webinar, where we covered the relief measures that has been provided in the first phase of COVID-19. Now we have reached to a second phase where we'll be discussing about the relief measures which has been provided considering the pandemic, and we'll try to cover in brief that what the government has to offer in the second phase in terms of the relaxations of regulatory reliefs and other aids to the industries and to boost up the economy. So friends, I have tried to gather and compile the data from the presentations made by the government in public domain, various circulars and government websites. today when we are discussing about the stimulus package. So let us try to understand what does stimulus package mean. So stimulus package is a package of economic measures put together by a government to stimulate a struggling economy. As we have witnessed, many of the countries in the last 15 to 20 days have announced such economic stimulus package to revive their economy, to boost up their economy and survive in this pandemic phase. So stimulus package is a coordinated efforts to increase the government spendings and lower the tax and the interest rates in order to stimulate an economy out of the recession or depression. It includes a number of incentives and tax rebates offered by a government to boost up the spendings. So let's begin with the topic for today's webinar, friends. So as discussed, the coverage for the topic will be brief on the self-reliant package of India of rupees 20 lakh crore. Second, the benefits to business and industries, including the MSME sector. Third, very important and crucial, the way forward considering the COVID-19, the converting the opportunities into reality, and some of the other important updates which we may be aware of. Friends, I would like to highlight that in this webinar, I have shortlisted and identified certain focus areas where I'll be discussing about the key benefits from this self-reliant package, the benefits useful to the industry, the benefits useful to the professionals for guidance and guiding their clients in turn. I have not covered the areas which is not directly related or useful to professionals in guiding further, like agriculture benefits, migrant benefits, benefits provided to fisheries sector, etc., which I'll be taking in brief when we'll discussing about the breakup of this package. So moving ahead, friends. What's new? What's new in this package? So आज के दिन तक हम सबको पता चल गया होगा कि the headline or the tagline or the quote which our honorable prime minister has provided is to be Atmanirbhar, or which we can say as self-reliant, and he has termed it as a self-reliant movement, covering under which they have provided various benefits we'll taking in this webinar. He has further provided 5 pillars for Atmanirbhar, and the tagline which the prime minister has advised us to boost upon is making vocal the local market. The summary of his message, if we can brief it in a 4 to 5 points, I would say that first is to boost up the local market. Second, a due importance has been given to MSME market and boosting up the MSME platform. Third, strengthening the banks, NBFCs, mutual funds and agriculture sector. And fourth, to promote the various industries including coal, mining, power, defense and PPP model, which will be taking in reform sector. So this is an extract from the presentations of government where Prime Minister's vision was shared, which included to call for Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan or self-reliant India movement, for which the Honorable Prime Minister has provided the 5 basic pillars, including the boosting up and growth of economy, infrastructure, system, vibrant demography and demand. So once we'll be at the conclusion stage of this discussion of this webinar, you will be able to realize that how effectively and beautifully this 5 pillars has been covered by the various reforms and the benefits that has been provided as an aid for the development of the economy. Further, as we all know, this package is of 20 lakh crores, which is equivalent to 10% of our country's GDP, friends. The package to cater to various sections, including the cottage industry, MSMEs, labors, middle class industries, among others. The bold reform across sector will drive the country's push towards self-reliance. It is now time to become vocal for our local products and make them global. So this was a clear indication from our prime ministers, and that was the vision which he shared with the entire nation. Now, the package was announced by Honorable Finance Minister, Honorable Prime Minister, but the various detailing was provided by Honorable finance minister Ms. Nirmala Sitaraman ji. So that session was divided into 5 days. In the period of 5 days, government tried to identify and bifurcate various benefits into various sectors, and they have grouped it into 5 phases. So first being the businesses, including MSMEs, on day one that was being discussed, which was on 30th of June, 30th of May. So from 30th to 17th of May, various products were being announced, totaling and aggregating to 20 lakh rupees. So the brief grouping of it, first being business, including MSMEs, second, the benefits to poor, including migrants and farmers, third being agriculture, fourth, it is very important, friends, new horizons of growth, where you will see the driving the country as a growth engine to be self-reliant, and last being government reforms and enablers. So now we'll be discussing about the how this 20 lakh has been bifurcated to various sectors, and what is the bifurcation of this 20 lakh package. So you can consider these 5 days as in part 1, part 2, part 3, part 4 and part 5. So first being overall stimulus provided by Atmanirbhar package. Just a minute, friends. Okay. So first we'll discuss about how this 20 lakh has been bifurcated into various parts. First part that we discussed, that is for businesses, that is of 5,94,550 crores. Part 2, 3,10,000. Part 3, 1,50,000. Part 4 and 5 aggregating to 48,100. So these 5 phases is aggregating to 11,02,650 crore rupees. Now the further bifurcation is earlier measures which were included under Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan package. So that will be covering in the later slide, which is totaling to 1,92,800 crore rupees. A humongous benefit is provided by our Apex Bank, which is RBI. It has taken various and multifold measures totaling to around 8,101,603 crore rupees. So that is out totaling to 20 lakh crore rupees. Now part one, the sub bifurcation for the MSME and business sector. This is the prime focus area of every practitioners and the businessmen, where the people are driving and focusing to utilize the package in this part one. So first is here emergency working capital facility for businesses, including MSMEs, that is a huge amount of 3 lakh crore rupees. Subordinate debt for stressed MSME, that is 20,000. Fund of funds for MSME, that is 50,000. EPF support for business and workers, that is 2,800. Reduction in EPF rates, 6,750. Special liquidity scheme for NBFC, HFC or mutual fund institutions, around 30,000. Partial credit guarantee again to NBFCs, that is of 45,000. Liquidity injection for DISCOM, which was a very affected sector, a 90,000 humongous fund has been provided. Reduction in TDS, TCS rate, 50,000. Friends, for your benefits and for the benefit of public at large, to the best of my understanding, out of this 5 phases, that is of business, poor, including migrant and farmers, agriculture, new horizons and government reforms, I think the first part is very crucial, which I have considered and collected and gathered in a very detailed manner for the discussion in this webinar. I have taken a brief about the fourth part, the new horizons, as it is the growth engine for our country, and some of the government reforms and enablers has also been considered in the presentation. So the remaining, the day 2, day 3 has not been considered considering the timeline of this webinar. So now part 2, where we'll be discussing about the bifurcations, so that we can have a brief or gist idea that how the fund has been allocated. So part 2 is for poor, including migrants and farmers, where free food grain supply to migrant workers for 2 months has been provided, for which 3,500 crore has been allocated. Interest subvention for Mudra Sishu loan, which we have covered, of 1500 special credit facilities to street vendors for 5000 rupees, housing CLSS MIG 70,000, additional emergency working capital through NABARD 30,000, additional credit through Kishan credit card that is 2 lakh. So you can see a great importance has been given to the poor sector, which is the major sector of our economy or our country. So a great work has been done by the government of India. Part 3, which is covering of agriculture, the prime sector of our country, where food and micro enterprises 10,000 has been bifurcated. Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana 20,000, top to total, where Operation Greens has been the topic, where 500 has been given. Agri Infrastructure Fund, a humongous fund of 1 lakh crore has been bifurcated. Animal Husbandry Infrastructure Development Fund 15,000. Promotion of Herbal Cultivation 4,000. Beekeeping Initiative 500. Totaling to 1,50,000. Part 4 and Part 5, where 8,100 has been funded for viability gap funding and 40,000 additional MNREGA allocation has been done. Further, of stimulus for earlier measures which we discussed, that 1,92,800 was bifurcated. First being revenue loss to tax concession since March 22nd, 7,800. Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan package 1,70,000 and PM announcement for health sector being 15,000. Now friends, if you have understood this 5 package, it is very visible at primary level, especially from this part 3. That humongous fund is bifurcated for infrastructure development being one of the pillar of the Atmanirbhar Yojana. So the key takeaways which we can consider from this package is, the package describes about 5 to 6 areas, one being banking, second being MSME, third being NBFC, fourth being RERA, fifth being direct tax reforms, 6 others where EPF and interest subvention will be covered. The main intention of this package is to boost up, strengthen and promote various industries and the various new models, including the coal mining, PPE at airports, defense, space, etc. Now all these key takeaways I'll take you through the entire webinar. First of all, starting with banking. So friends, banking being a very critical and primary sector of our economy, because that directly links with the finance part. So a crucial role has been played by RBI, and various changes, relaxations and modifications has been made so as that the poor to poor and the industrialist or businessman gets the best out of these benefits. So we'll start first with the RBI by the circular dated 23rd of 2020 of May has provided certain COVID-19 regulatory package, that relaxations is mainly bifurcated into 4 parts. That is, first, rescheduling payments, as jaise humne pehle webinar mein cover kiya tha ki rescheduling has been provided with respect to the moratorium period. There are further extensions into that that will be covering. Second, easing of working capital finance. Third, relaxation in asset classification norms. And fourth, the other criterias. So this is a gross view where we can see that we have moved from lockdown 4 to unlock 1, where the government is now trying to open up the economy, trying to open up all the businesses with due core, forming up SOPs and forming up various regulations for the safety of the public at large. So these 4 benefits are very crucial for a business to run, survive and get a financial support. So let's discuss that. The first one, banking. The first topic is rescheduling the payments. That will be covered in 2 parts. First being term loan and second being working capital facilities. First, term loans. Banks are permitted. Mark here, friends, banks are permitted. Banks are not instructed. They are permitted. Means the banks has an option to avail or not to avail this benefit, to extend the moratorium by another 3 months. that is from June 1, 2020 to August 31st, 2020 on payment of all installments in respect of term loans. So, जैसे हमने देखा था कि इसमें previously 3 months of moratorium period was provided, which has now further been extended for further 3 months, that is June to August. Accordingly, the repayment schedule for such loans as also the residual tenure will be shifted across the board. मतलब ये हमने पहले वेबिनार में भी कवर किया था, बट कवरिंग इन शॉर्ट, बाय कंसीडरिंग द मॉरेटोरियम पीरियड, होता क्या है, फॉर एग्जांपल यू कंसीडर योर लोन ऑफ से इंस्टॉलमेंट, हाउसिंग लोन लिया और आपकी 50 इंस्टॉलमेंट्स है. अब उसमें अगर मॉरेटोरियम पीरियड का कवर आता है, इफ यू ऑप्ट फॉर इट एंड बैंक प्रोवाइड फॉर इट, बोथ गोज इन विन विन सिचुएशन, देन पहले 3 मंथ था, मान लो कि आपने वो 3 मंथ में ऑप्ट किया था फॉर moratorium. Now you are further opting considering your financial weakness, you are further opting over 3 months. So 50 se 53 hua tha, now wo 53 se badke 56 number of installments ho jayega, aur jahan pe ye moratorium period hai wahan pe wo zero ho jayega aur wo 50 se 56 elongate ho jayega. But the point to be noted here is interest shall continue to accrue on the outstanding portion of the term loans during the moratorium period. It is very crucial. RBI ne various FAQs bhi diye hai. One who has still confusion whether to opt or not can refer the MCQs or the FAQs which has been provided on their website, jahan pe various basic level questions has been drafted and has been answered wonderfully. So you can definitely refer to it if you still have doubt whether to opt for it or not. Second is working capital facilities. Very crucial and very important. As the economy has opened up, businesses are going to start. So working capital also reads as permitted to allow. So that is also optional again. A deferment of another 3 months from June 1 to August 31st on recovery of interest applied in respect of all such facilities. Friends, difference between the two is in term loan there is principal as well as interest, both you get moratorium, but here you are getting moratorium for interest component. The lending institutions are permitted at their discretion to convert the accumulated interest for the deferment period up to August 31st 2020 into a new term, that is funded interest term loan. This is not a new term, but the people who are not attached or working closely with the banks, this is a new term for them, which is FITL, which shall be repayable not later than March 31, 2021. So just to brief to the participants who do not know what is FITL. So what it is, say for example, in this moratorium period of 6 months, if you opted for moratorium or वहाँ पे interest आपका apply हो रहा है, तो वो जो इंटरेस्ट कंपोनेंट आपका है, लोन तो चली रही है आपकी वर्किंग कैपिटल, बट वो लोन के ऊपर जो इंटरेस्ट ड्यू हो रहा है, तो दैट इंटरेस्ट कंपोनेंट को, ओनली इंटरेस्ट कंपोनेंट इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू अ लोन. तो वो जो इंटरेस्ट कंपोनेंट के लिए लोन कन्वर्ट की गई, उसे कहा जाता है फंडेड इंटरेस्ट टर्म लोन. तो बैंक इज अनदर, दिस इज अ सेकेंड ऑप्शन विच हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड. इफ द बोरोवर वॉन्ट्स टू ऑप्ट फॉर इट, they can go for converting their interest component into a loan which is termed as FITL, and that shall be paid not later than March 31st 2021. Second phase, that is easing of working capital financing. So in respect of working capital facilities sanctioned in the form of CC or OD, that is cash credit or overdraft, to borrowers facing stress on account of the economic fallout of the pandemic, lending institutions as a one-time measure. Market friends, this is only a one-time measure where two options has been provided. First being recalculate the DP by reducing the margins till 31st August 2020. However, in all such cases where such a temporary enhancement in DP is considered, the margin shall be restored to the original levels by March 31st, 2021. Now, let me explain you how this works. Say for example, aapki koi bank mein CC ya OD facility is going on. So how that is being worked out, you are supposed to submit the stock statements and the debtors position, current assets position on periodical basis. जिसके बेसिस पे आपकी डीपी कैलकुलेट होती है. नाउ हाउ द डीपी इज बीइंग कैलकुलेटेड, डीपी दैट इज ड्रॉइंग पावर, हाउ दैट इज बीइंग कैलकुलेटेड. सो द टोटल नेट करंट असेट्स पोजीशन व्हिच यू आर हैविंग, फ्रॉम दैट अ मार्जिन इज बीइंग डिडक्टेड. स्टॉक प्लस डेटर्स माइनस क्रेडिटर्स, और देयर इज अनदर फॉर्मूला, स्टॉक प्लस डेटर्स टोटल. से फॉर एग्जांपल स्टॉक वाज ऑफ 75 रुपीस, debtors was of 25 rupees totaling to 100, out of which creditors was 50, so totaling comes to 50 pe margin hota hai, say for example 20%, so margin ho gaya aapka 20%, to aapki dp ho gayi 40, to wo 40 rupees pe aapka dp chalega aur aapki cc aur od ki limit wo 40 tak rahegi. Now there is another formula for calculation provided by iba. Stock plus debtors is equal to total, arrive at amount less margin minus creditors and then the net DP. So wherever, jahan pe main focus is on reducing the margin, generally it ranges from 20 to 25% based on the financial strength of the borrower. So yahan pe RBI ne aisa kaha hai ki they have permitted banks to reduce that margin portion. So automatically your drawing power limits will increase and you will get a further fund. And the second option is review the working capital sanction limits up to March 31, 2021 based on the reassessment of the working capital cycle. So ye do benefit diye gaye hai in case of not directly funding but indirectly funding on the basis of your strength, or revisiting these funds sanctioned or reducing the margins. Moving ahead friends, asset classification being one of the prime areas in the bank audit and the banking entire sector. So yahan pe benefit ye relaxation diya gaya hai ki the conversion of accumulated interest into FITL and the changes in the credit terms permitted to the borrower to specifically tide over economic fallout will not be treated as concessions granted due to financial difficulty of the borrower under the so-and-so paragraph of RBI so-and-so directions, and consequently will not result in asset classification downgrade. Friends, abhi jo maine explain kiya aapko FITL. So FITL is generally observed where account is being restructured or where the account is facing financial crisis or financial problem where it may tentatively get converted into NPA. So us time pe this facility is being provided. To ye relaxation diya gaya ki agar आपने ये रिलैक्सेशन ऑफ कन्वर्टिंग इंटरेस्ट कंपोनेंट इनटू एफआईटीएल ऑप्ट किया है, तो आपका आपका जो एफआईटीएल पोर्शन है दैट विल नॉट बी कंसीडर्ड एज रिस्ट्रक्चर्ड एंड दैट विल नॉट रिजल्ट इन डाउनवर्ड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ योर बोरोइंग्स. फर्दर इन रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ अकाउंट्स क्लासिफाइड एज स्टैंडर्ड एज ऑन February 29, 2020, रिसेंटली अभी स्टेचुटरी ऑडिट खत्म हुए या कुछ बैंकों के खत्म होंगे, तो यहाँ पे आपको जिन्होंने बैंक ऑडिट्स किए हैं February 29, 2020 दिमाग में एक डेट छप गई है, बिकॉज आरबीआई ने ये प्रमोट किया है कि जनरली ईयर एंड पे आप क्लासिफिकेशन देखते हो असेट का. इन क्वार्टर फोर केस 31 मार्च को हम देखेंगे कि वेदर असेट इज बींग कन्वर्टेड इन टू एनपीए और सब स्टैंडर्ड और नॉट. तो वहां पे ड्यू टू कंसिडरिंग दिस मॉरिटोरियम पीरियड एंड द आरबीआई गाइडलाइंस, the NPA as on 29th February 2020 ka jo status tha use consider karna tha for the purpose of classification. So in respect of account classified as standard as on February 29, 2020, even if overdue, the moratorium period wherever granted in respect of term loans shall be excluded by the lending institutions from the number of days past due for the purpose of asset classification under IRAC norms. The asset classification for such accounts shall be determined on the basis of revised due dates and the revised repayment schedule. Jaise humne abhi aage discuss kiya ki there around home loan 50 installments were there, which has now been converted to 56 considering the moratorium period of 6 months. So now the banks has to consider that 56 number of installments for the purpose of identification of NPA. Correct. The last relaxation that has been provided in asset classification is with respect to working capital facility, where the deferment period wherever granted in terms of shall be excluded for the determination of out of order status. Term loan में repayment schedule के basis पे होता है, CC में पहले वो out of order होता है, which is as per RBI guidelines कि certain days में आप अगर payment नहीं करते या there are certain conditions on classification or on identification of which an account turns out of order, तो वो status भी नहीं देना है उन accounts, उन borrower accounts को जिन्होंने ये facility avail की है. So as you can see कि टर्म लोन और वर्किंग कैपिटल में जो एग्जिस्टिंग बोरोवर्स है और इनका एग्जिस्टिंग फंडिंग चल रहा है उनको ही मेजर बेनिफिट दिए गए हैं. रीजन बीइंग जिनका एग्जिस्टिंग लोन चल रहा है उनको ही इंटरेस्ट और कैपिटल रीपेमेंट का बर्डन होगा, तो वो बर्डन को इज आउट किया गया है बाय वे ऑफ दिस फैसिलिटीज. द लास्ट अंडर द बैंकिंग इज अदर वेयर एन एक्सटेंशन ऑफ पीरियड ऑफ एडवांस इन केस ऑफ प्री शिपमेंट एंड पोस्ट शिपमेंट एक्सपोर्ट क्रेडिट हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड. And the circular which has been provided by RBI dated May 23 states that RBI has already permitted, मतलब इसमें भी extension का case है, that's why it is being stated RBI has already permitted the period of realization and repatriation of the export proceeds to India to be increased from 9 months to 15 months from the date of export in respect of export made up to July 31st 2020. In line with this relaxation, it has been now decided to increase the maximum permissible period of pre-shipment and post-shipment export credit from 1 year to 15 months for disbursement made up to 31st July 2020. So again, this is to boost up the export and import, jahan pe repatriation of fund or various conditions has to be fulfilled. So that has been extended from 1 year to 15 months. Moving ahead in the package, friends, we have moved ahead from banking. Now moving ahead to business sector, including MSME part 1, agar aapko yaad ho to. Jahan pe government ne specifically 15 benefits outline kiye hai, jise main one by one ek bar read kar leta hu, which will be covering in further slides. First being 3 lakh crore collateral free automatic loans business, including MSME. 20,000 crore subordinate debt for MSMEs. 50,000 crore equity infusion through MSME, fund of funds, new definition of MSME, global tender to be disallowed up to 200 crores, this is also for MSME, other interventions for MSME. Yahan pe jo friends aap dekhenge 1 to 6, all is to boost up MSME. 3 lakh crore collateral, pehla jo hai, collateral fee loan, second is subordinate debt, third is fund of funds. ये तीनों में क्या डिफरेंस है वो हम आगे कवर करेंगे. सेवेंथ 2500 करोड़ ईपीएफ सपोर्ट टू बिजनेसेस एंड वर्कर्स फॉर मोर देन 3 मंथ्स, ईपीएफ कंट्रीब्यूशन रिड्यूस्ड फॉर बिजनेस एंड वर्कर्स फॉर 3 मंथ्स. अब ये 7 और 8 वो भी थोड़ा डाइसी है जिसे हम आगे कवर करेंगे. नाइन्थ 30,000 करोड़ लिक्विडिटी फैसिलिटी फॉर एनबीएफसी कवर करेंगे आगे. 45,000 करोड़ पार्शियल क्रेडिट गारंटी स्कीम 2.0 फॉर एनबीएफसीज. 90,000 करोड़ लिक्विडिटी इंजेक्शन फॉर डिस्कॉम्स. डिस्कॉम्स का अराउंड 94,000 करोड़ इज ड्यू विद गवर्नमेंट, तो जहां पे लिक्विडिटी इंजेक्शन करेगा गवर्नमेंट अप टू 90,000, सो अ बिग रिलीफ टू प्रमोट द डिस्कॉम सेक्टर. रिलीफ टू कॉन्ट्रैक्टर्स, एक्सटेंशन ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड कंप्लीशन ऑफ डेट ऑफ रियल एस्टेट प्रोजेक्ट्स दैट इज अंडर रेरा विच विल बी कवरिंग. 50,000 करोड़ लिक्विडिटी थ्रू टीडीएस टीसीएस एंड अदर डायरेक्ट टैक्स रिफॉर्म. सो ऑल दिस मेजरली 15 में से 13 14 हमने अगर डिटेल्ड में कवर किए हैं, which will be go ahead. First and the prime most being MSME, the vision of India 2.0. Jab ye package announce hua on day one, plus the aggressive policy framing, the reforms being brought in under MSME sector by Honorable Nitin Gadkari ji is appreciable. And many benefits has been provided by them through these policies and reforms. Outlining these 6 benefits, first being rupees 3 lakh crore collateral fee automatic loans. Automatic loans kya hai wo hum aage dekhenge, collateral fee dena hai kaise dena hai, kya eligibility norms hai, which has been described. Mark here including MSMEs. 22nd 20,000 crore subordinate debt. Ab ye jo 6 point hai, this is specifically for MSME, to maine yahan pe repeatedly liya hai taki hamara focus rahe for MSME. थर्ड 50,000 करोड़ फंड ऑफ फंड, न्यू फंड ऑफ फंड्स में ये कहना चाहूंगा कि फंड ऑफ फंड्स जो है वहां पे गवर्नमेंट इज गोइंग टू आइडेंटिफाई दी वायबल एमएसएमई प्रोजेक्ट्स, जहां पे गवर्नमेंट विल स्टडी इट इन डेप्थ वेर एवर दे फाउंड दैट दिस एमएसएमई इज ग्रोथ ओरिएंटेड एंड हैज द पोटेंशियल टू ग्रो, तो वहां पे गवर्नमेंट विल टेक स्टेक इन द एमएसएमई. बट द डिटेल्ड पॉलिसी जो है दैट इज बीइंग अवेटेड. द स्कीम डिटेल्स हैज बीन मेड अवेलेबल बट ऑर्डिनेंस और द प्रॉपर फॉर्म ऑफ सर्क्यूलर इज येट टू रिसीव, बट बैंक्स आर अंडर द प्रोसेस टू इवेलुएट एंड इम्प्लीमेंट द सेम. द न्यू डेफिनेशन ऑफ एमएसएमई हैज ऑल्सो बीन प्रोवाइडेड, वहां पे स्कोप वाइडन किया गया है, वो हम आगे कवर करेंगे. ग्लोबल टेंडर्स टू बी डिसअलाउड अप टू 200 crores. बाय दिस पॉइंट गवर्नमेंट इज ट्राइंग टू हाईलाइट दैट अप टू 200 crore rupees वी वॉन्ट एमएसएमई ऑफ आर कंट्री टू बीड इन दोज टेंडर्स एंड बी मोर सेल्फ रिलायंट एंड मूव टूवर्ड्स आत्मनिर्भर भारत. Sixth, being other interventions for MSME which includes receivables from government and CPSEs to be realized in 45 days, enhance the transaction based lending using the data generated by e-marketplace, etc. Now friends, MSME ek aisa sector aajkal ho gaya hai due to the hue and cry which you might be hearing from here and there, especially the professionals, because the way the MSME has been projected by the government, people are driving towards small retailers ya to fir small companies which are covering under the MSME, so they are trying to promote and boost up their business and utilize the benefits under this scheme that in turn will help the country and growing the economy in turn. So this 3 lakh package, let's discuss about it, sir. 3 lakh crore collateral free automatic loans for business including MSMEs. So what are the eligibility norms? First, emergency credit line to businesses or MSME from banks and NBFCs up to 20% of the entire outstanding credit as on 29th of Feb. Friends, ye jo facility dene wale hai MSME ko, that is not on the basis of the limit sanctioned ya to fir unki capacity, but the point is outstanding credit of those borrowers as on date 29th of February, plus an add-on condition, that is who are under SMA 0 or 1 bucket. So for those who are not aware with SMA, SMA is a special mention accounts 0 and 1 and 2. So ye kaam aayega, let me explain it. SMA 0 use kaha jata hai jin borrowers ka outstanding balance is due या तो फिर ओवरड्यू बिटवीन 0 टू 30 डेज, सो दे विल फॉल अंडर एसएमए 0. इफ योर ओवरड्यू इज बिटवीन 31 टू 60 डेज, देन यू विल फॉल अंडर एसएमए 1 बकेट, एंड इफ इट इज ओवरड्यू मोर देन 61 टू 90, जहां पे 90 के बाद आप पोटेंशियली एनपीए में टर्न हो सकते हो, तो वो अकाउंट्स को एसएमए 2 कैटेगरी कहा जाता है. मैंने यहां पे टेक्निकल वर्ड यूज किया है, दैट इज यहां पे ऐसा कहा गया है कि जिन-जिन अकाउंट्स का outstanding balance 29th 2 ko jo hai, and if they are falling under the bracket of SMA 0 or 1, to unko 20% of further funding kiya jayega. Wahan pe borrower with up to 25 crore fund based outstanding and 100 crore turnover are eligible. To bade bhi cover nahi kiye gaye, borrowers jinka fund based outstanding, friends, participants, it is very crucial. यहाँ पे outstanding दिया गया है, which is to be interpreted here as fund-based outstanding should be up to 25 crore and the turnover should not exceed 100 crore rupees. Third, loans to have 4-year tenure with moratorium of 12 months on principal repayment. So moratorium जैसे हमने explain किया आगे, this loan will be of 4 years. जहां पे पहले साल में मॉरेटोरियम रहेगा और बाकी के 3 साल में आपका पेमेंट रहेगा, करेक्ट. पर यहां पे ध्यान ये रखना है, मॉरेटोरियम ऑफ 12 मंथ इज फॉर प्रिंसिपल रीपेमेंट, फ्रेंड्स. तो फॉर द मॉरेटोरियम पीरियड ऑफ 12 मंथ्स इंटरेस्ट कंपोनेंट हैज टू बी पेड, बट लेटर ऑन बाकी के 3 साल में उनको प्रिंसिपल प्लस इंटरेस्ट दोनों पे करना है. अब इंटरेस्ट इज टू बी कैप्ड, इंटरेस्ट इज टू बी कैप्ड, तो उसका मतलब ये होता है यहाँ पे दैट इज टू बी फ्रीज्ड अप टू सर्टेन लेवल. जनरली हमने देखा होगा कि बेस प्लस 1%, एमसीएलआर प्लस 1% ऐसे रेट्स रहते हैं, तो यहाँ पे फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन केस ऑफ बैंक्स 9.25% इज द कैप विच हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड एंड 14% कैप हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड इन केस ऑफ एनबीएफसीज. द मेन बेनिफिट ओवर हियर इज 100% क्रेडिट गारंटी कवर विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द बैंक्स एंड एनबीएफसीज ऑन प्रिंसिपल एज वेल एज इंटरेस्ट बाय एजेंसी दैट इज एनसीजीटी दैट इज नेशनल क्रेडिट गारंटी ट्रस्ट कंपनी. The scheme can be availed up to 31st October 2020 or utilization of 3 lakh crores, whichever is earlier. And the last one, the main benefit is no guarantee fees for the point number 5 where guarantees is being covered or no fresh collateral has to be obtained. So this is one of the very prime key hit where MSME wants to take the fund. So if we recap, I can say, ये उन बोरोवर को एलिजिबल है जिनका आउटस्टैंडिंग बैलेंस एज ऑन 29th ऑफ फेब इज नॉट फॉलिंग विद इन द ब्रैकेट बियॉन्ड एसएमए 1. उनको अप टू 20% ऑफ फर्दर फंडिंग दिया जाएगा इमरजेंसी क्रेडिट लाइन के तौर में. उनका वो एमएसएमई जिनका बोरोइंग फंड आउटस्टैंडिंग जो है वो 25 करोड़ तक या उससे नीचे है और उनका टर्नओवर 100 करोड़ या उससे नीचे है. अब ये जो 25 करोड़ 100 करोड़ है वो हम आगे डिस्कस करेंगे. लोन्स जो है उसका रीपेमेंट पीरियड रहेगा 4 साल, जिसमें से पहले साल में मॉरेटोरियम ऑफ प्रिंसिपल कंपोनेंट नॉट इंटरेस्ट कंपोनेंट और बाकी के 3 साल में आपका रहेगा इंटरेस्ट प्लस इंस्टॉलमेंट ईएमआई के फॉर्म में. इंटरेस्ट जो रहेगा वो भी एक लिमिट तक आपका फ्रीज है ताकि वो फ्लक्चुएट नहीं होगा अप टू एन हायर अमाउंट. मेन बेनिफिट कोलेट्रल नहीं देना है जहां पे एजेंसी गवर्नमेंट की प्रोवाइड करेगी कोलेट्रल टू बैंक्स एंड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस. ना ही आपका कोई गारंटी फी कलेक्ट किया जाएगा या स्कीम जो है वो 31st अक्टूबर 2020 तक है इफ यू वांट टू अवेल और 3 लाख यूटिलाइजेशन व्हिच एवर इज अर्लियर. अब सबऑर्डिनेट डेट फॉर स्ट्रेस्ड एमएसएमई. तो व्हाट डज सबऑर्डिनेट डेट एलिजिबिलिटी नॉर्म सेज एंड द अदर पॉइंट्स व्हिच हैज बीन मेंशनड इन द गवर्नमेंट्स डेटा. So first point is functioning of MSME which are NPA or are stressed will be eligible. So friends, ये उन MSME की बात है जो either SMA 2 में है मतलब stressed या तो फिर NPA में convert हो चुके हैं. तो see government's vision is very clear. Even though you are in NPA category, we want you to boost up. We will infuse funds with you, but what our aim is be self-reliant. Second point, government will provide a support of 4,000 crore. To CGTMSE, that is Credit Guarantee Fund Trust for micro and small enterprises. The CGTMSE will provide partial credit support guarantee support to the banks. Promoters of the MSME will be given debt by the banks, which will then be infused by the promoters as equity in the unit. I'm not taking it into detail because detailed guidelines are notified, but every bank will form their own policies and structures. So banks are under the process to evaluate. So it will be an early stage to discuss about the same. But this is just a brief. जहाँ पे अगर आप compare करो तो 3 lakh collateral free loan है वो उनके लिए है जो assured है. Government को लगता है these are the borrowers who are making payment due in time and falling within the bucket of good borrowers. जो borrower NPA में convert हो चुके हैं या तो फिर stress है उनके लिए भी हमारे लिए provision है. उनको CGTMSE के द्वारा बेनिफिट दिया जाएगा. नाउ जो हम बात कर रहे थे डेफिनेशन चेंज किया गया है टू ब्रॉडन द स्कोप ऑफ MSME ताकि मोर एंड मोर MSME इज प्रमोटेड इन द कंट्री. प्रीवियस वेबिनार में जहां पे हमने डिस्कस किया था कि जो MSME की डेफिनेशन है वहां पे बेसिकली इफ वी सी देयर आर 3 categories ऑफ एंटरप्राइजेस अंडर MSME. फर्स्ट माइक्रो एंटरप्राइज, सेकेंड स्मॉल एंटरप्राइज एंड थर्ड इज मीडियम एंटरप्राइज. पहले यहाँ पे सिर्फ इन्वेस्टमेंट के क्राइटेरिया थे जो कि अब टर्नओवर को भी इंक्लूड किया गया है फॉर इन द डेफिनेशन क्राइटेरिया. तो कॉम्बिनेशन में देखना है हमें. फॉर माइक्रो पहले अभी पेंडेमिक फर्स्ट के टाइम पे था फर्स्ट 1 crore और टर्नओवर 5 crore विच हैज रिमेन इंटैक्ट. अभी प्रीवियसली मतलब कल ही ये नोटिफिकेशन आया है. But remember, it is applicable from July 1, 2020, friends. Second, small enterprises. Agar small enterprises, let me explain this. Small enterprises, agar investment in plant and machinery jo hai, if it is below 10 crores, एंड उनका टर्नओवर 50 करोड़ तक है तो दे आर फॉलिंग विद इन दिस डेफिनेशन, दैट इज ऑल्सो रिमेन इंटेक्ट. बट फ्रेंड्स यहाँ पे आप देखिए तीसरी डेफिनेशन, जहां पे इन्वेस्टमेंट इन प्लांट एंड मशीनरी इज अप टू 20 करोड़ रुपीज एंड टर्नओवर अप टू 100 करोड़, जो हमने आगे डिस्कस किया, करेक्ट, ये रहा. अब वो चेंज करके किया गया है 50 करोड़ रुपीज ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट इन प्लांट एंड मशीनरी एंड टर्नओवर अप टू 250 करोड़. अब ये क्यों किया गया? वेरियस एसोसिएशंस एंड बॉडीज हैज रिप्रेजेंटेड टू गवर्नमेंट कि आपका जो एम है एमएसएमई को प्रमोट करना, तो मेजर इज क्रक्स लाइज इन मीडियम एंटरप्राइजेस. और अगर आप 20 करोड़ का इन्वेस्टमेंट और टर्नओवर 100 करोड़ का कैप अगर डाल रहे हो, तो इट विल नॉट सॉल्व योर पर्पस ऑफ कवरिंग मेजोरिटी ऑफ द एंटिटीज अंडर एमएसएमई एंड प्रमोटिंग दैट. सो कंसीडरिंग दैट गवर्नमेंट फेवर्ड बाय चेंजिंग द डेफिनेशन एंड एक्सपांडिंग द होराइजंस ऑफ द डेफिनेशंस where investment in plant and machinery can be up to 50 crore rupees and turnover up to 250 crore is allowed to fall within the definition of MSME. Now friends, aapko bahut sare sawal honge ki which MSMEs are eligible to claim these benefits, what are the rules and the policies, bank jo funding hame degi to usme kya kya viability check karegi funding ke liye, SMA 2 category MSME jo cover nahi kiye gaye unke liye kya, वॉट आर दी डिटेल गाइडलाइंस जो हम फॉलो करें, हमारे क्लाइंट को अप्रोच करें, जो हमें क्लाइंट को गाइड करें, जो हमें अप्रोच कर रहे हैं, द वे एमएसएमई हैज बीन इन टॉक्स दिस डेज, जैसे मैंने बताया, आर देयर एक्चुअल बेनिफिट्स टू देम, क्वेश्चंस आर मेनी बट रिजोल्यूशंस आर अंडर प्रोसेस. अब ये एक मैंने फ्रेम लिया है जो एक समरी फॉर्म में था फ्रॉम द पीपीटी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट. ये हमने जो कवर किया अभी 3 लाख करोड़, then no global tender for 200 crore, then this EPF benefit, then EPF benefit again, correct, TDS benefits. अब यहाँ पे आप गौर से देखिए, I have highlighted the portion businesses including MSME, in MSME and other business, in MSME and other business, though government is promoting and highlighting MSME sector, but these benefits in turn are for the entire industry because this fact highlights for business including MSME. It means MSME is part of business. That means that these benefits are not solely for MSMEs. Correct. So then what are the specific benefits for MSME? So as Virag bhai told me that these benefits will be covered in a special webinar on MSME to be launched in the next week or period to come. So this will be for benefit of all those people who are working in MSME or who have received many requests for the MSME, how to grow it and how to take the benefits. Correct. The webinar will also include, this is a USP of that benefit, the webinar will also include the benefits for a CA practicing firm for getting registered under MSME. So that will be a very limelight topic in that webinar. Now friends, MSME we have covered up. Now NBFCs, जैसे कि हम पिछले समय से देखते आ रहे हैं कि MSME has been a rising backbone for funding apart from banking and financial institutions. So various benefits has also been provided by the government, various capital infusions is also being done. So special liquidity scheme for NBFC, क्या कहता है वो कि government will launch a 30,000 crore special liquidity scheme. Under this scheme, investment will be made in both primary and secondary market transactions in investment grade debt paper of NBFCs, HFCs or MFIs. So indirectly, government is investing in those NBFCs by this humongous fund of 30,000 crores, which in turn will infuse the financial soundness of those NBFCs and will help those NBFCs to promote and lend further. It will, as I said, it will supplement RBI government measures to augment liquidity. Securities will be fully guaranteed by Government of India. So this is a great measure. This will provide liquidity support to NBFCs, HFCs, MFIs and mutual funds and create confidence in the market. So government बैंकिंग बेनिफिट्स हमने देखे, एमएसएमई बेनिफिट्स हमने देखे, अब एनबीएफसी बेनिफिट्स हम देख रहे हैं. core and the bottom line, bottom point which government has kept, and they're very clear. We want to infuse funds in the economy. We want to support the growing businesses in the country. So these measures can rightly speak about the government's motive to support those initiatives. The second is the partial credit guarantee scheme 2.0 for NBFCs. यहाँ पे मेन पॉइंट इज एग्जिस्टिंग PCGS. What is PCGS? Partial Credit Guarantee Scheme to be extended to cover borrowings of the entities of first 20% of the loss वो बॉन किया जाएगा गारंटर के द्वारा और गारंटर कौन रहेगा फ्रेंड्स गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया सो दिस इज अनदर अ स्टेप टू बूस्टन एंड स्ट्रेंथन द एनबीएफसीज नाउ मूविंग अहेड टू रेरा सो फ्रेंड्स रेरा में जैसे कि हम देख रहे हैं गवर्नमेंट ने जो बात की टू बूस्ट अप द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द कंपनी तो जब इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलप होगा तो हाउसिंग डेवलप होंगे तो रेरा विल कम इनटू पिक्चर नाउ रेरा जब से इंट्रोड्यूस हुआ है तब से लाइट में है तो उसे अब स्टार्ट करते हैं डिस्कस करना अब मेन प्राइम लाइन इज सुओ मोटो एक्सटेंशन ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड कंप्लीशन डेट दैट विल बी एक्सटेंडेड व्हाट विल बी एक्सटेंडेड दैट इज रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड कंप्लीशन डेट जो है रेरा व्हेन यू आर ट्राइंग टू रजिस्टर योर प्रोजेक्ट विद रेरा अथॉरिटीज तो वहां पे हमारा जो प्रोजेक्ट है जो रजिस्ट्रेशन मतलब फर्स्ट बीइंग एट द स्टार्ट ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट एंड सेकंड बीइंग द कंप्लीशन डेट तो उन केसेस में वहां पे गवर्नमेंट ने ऐसा कहा है कि दैट विल बी सुओ मोटो एक्सटेंडेड फॉर अ फर्दर पीरियड ऑफ 6 months फॉर ऑल द रजिस्टर्ड प्रोजेक्ट्स एक्सपायरिंग ऑन और आफ्टर कब 25 मार्च 2020 विदाउट इंडिविजुअल एप्लीकेशंस सो दैट्स अ ग्रेट रिलीफ नो प्रोसीजरल कंप्लायंस No document to be submitted, it will be suo moto extended up to 6 months. Second, regulatory authorities may extend this for another period of up to 3 months if needed. So, jaise humne aage discuss kiya, moratorium period extended for further 3 months. Aage hum dusra EPF aur usme dekhenge, jahan pe bhi 3 month extension ki baat ki gayi hai. In the similar fashion, RERA authorities, if deemed up, then they may further extend up to 3 months. उसमें फर्दर दो पॉइंट्स ये भी कहे गए हैं कि दे विल इश्यू फ्रेश प्रोजेक्ट रजिस्ट्रेशन सर्टिफिकेट्स ऑटोमेटिकली विथ रिवाइज्ड टाइमलाइंस दे विल एक्सटेंड द टाइमलाइंस फॉर वेरियस स्टैट्यूटरी कंप्लायंसेस अंडर रेरा कॉन्करेंटली तो अंडर दिस रेरा फेज ऑल्सो यू कैन सी गवर्नमेंट इज ट्राइंग टू बी मोर सपोर्टिव टू द बिजनेस पीपल नाउ द वेरी क्रूशियल एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डायरेक्ट टैक्स रिफॉर्म्स Which is covered. ये सबसे पहले हम कवर करेंगे उसके अंदर TDS rate reduction which we face on day to day basis. Correct. So first of all, the main change which has been observed here is the reduction in the TDS rates from 100% to 25%. Now what is that 100 to 25%? So that reads as the rates of TDS. For non-seller right specified payments, मैंने जो PPT में पूरे PPT में जहां पे भी red highlight किया है या blue से अलावा highlight किया, that are the key points. उस पे ध्यान जरूर दीजिएगा. For non-seller right specified payments made to residents and rates of TCS for the specified receipt shall be reduced by 25% of the existing rates. तो उसका मतलब क्या हुआ, friends? From 100%, it has been reduced by 25% to 75%. से फॉर एग्जाम्पल 194J के अंदर मेरा TDS कटता है 10% अंदर प्रोफेशनल सर्विसेज तो वो अब रिड्यूस होके 7.5 हो जाएगा रेट चार्ट विथ अ गवर्नमेंट रिलीज हैज बीन प्रोवाइडेड यू कैन डेफिनेटली रिफर इट हर एक सेक्शन वाइज दिया गया है बट वॉट आई वॉन्ट टू हाईलाइट हियर इज इट इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल फर्स्ट टू नॉन सेलराइड स्पेसिफाइड पेमेंट करेक्ट इट इज नॉट एप्लीकेबल टू सेलराइड पेमेंट सॉरी सो अगर आप एम्प्लॉयमेंट में हो और आपकी सैलरी के टीडीएस की बात है तो इट इज इन द सेम लाइन जो पहले डिडक्ट होता था उसकी तरह से Second, this is not applicable to foreign remittances. मतलब this is applicable solely to domestic payments. अब इसका ऑब्जेक्टिव क्या था गवर्नमेंट का ये लाने के पीछे, इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोवाइड मोर फंड्स एट द डिस्पोजल ऑफ द टैक्स पेयर्स. से फॉर एग्जांपल 100 रुपीस का मैंने इनवॉइस रेस किया है, 10% टीडीएस कट के आता था, तो आई यूज टू रिसीव 90 रुपीस एंड रिमेनिंग 10 आई यूज टू रिसीव एट द ईयर एंड व्हेन माय रिटर्न वॉज फाइल्ड एंड व्हेन माय टीडीएस वॉज एडजस्टेड. नाउ गवर्नमेंट ने क्या किया, वो टीडीएस रेट्स ही रिड्यूस कर दिए, जिसकी वजह से अगर मैं 100 रुपीस का बिल रखता हूँ तो my TDS will be deducted at 7.5, तो I will receive 92.5 rupees on my hand instead of 90, so that 2.5 more cash I am receiving at the initial period. So coverage will be payment of contract, professional fees, interest, rent, dividend, commission, etc. अब ये applicable कब से लेकर कब tenure तक होगा, तो that was announced on 13th or 14th, so that will be covering between the period May 14, 2020 to 31st March 2021. Ye period ke andar these rates will be effective. Now other direct tax reforms, it is more or less same in the line of previous reforms. Jahan pe sabse pehla hai pending refunds, jo bhi hai shall be issued immediately. Kis kis ke? Charitable trust, non-corporate business, professionals including proprietor, partner, LLP, cooperatives, etc. Jo due date of income tax return hai, that has been extended from 31st July to 31st October and now to 31st November 2020. Or TDS, or a tax audit jo hai, that has been extended from 30th September to 31st October 2020. The date of assessment which was getting barred has been on, kab kaun si date ko barred ho rahi thi, 30th September 2020. वो असेसमेंट का पीरियड बढ़ा 3 महीने बढ़ा के एक्सटेंडेड अप टू 31st December 2020, और जो बार हो रहे थे 31st March 2021 को उनके अंदर 6 महीने एक्सटेंड किया गया, दैट इज नाउ 30th September 2021. पीरियड ऑफ विवाद से विश्वास स्कीम फॉर मेकिंग पेमेंट विदाउट एडिशनल अमाउंट विल बी एक्सटेंडेड टू 31st December 2020, सो दैट्स एन इनफ पीरियड for all those assessees who are covered under this and are due for making the payment. EPF, my favorite area, because many of the small enterprises or the companies or financial institutions are facing issues in understanding or implying the changes that has been notified. So EPF do tarike se diya gaya hai. First is under Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan package, jahan pe payment of 12% of employer and 12% of employee contribution EPF में करना है of eligible establishment को. तो वो government ने कहा कि under the scheme of PMGKP हम वो payment करेंगे. वो जो announcement था जो हमने previous बार discuss किया, that was for the period March, April and May 2020. That has now been extended to 3 months salary for June, July and August. Eligibility. मैं काम करता हूँ prepared a comparative, तो वो ही समझा देता हूँ, that will be more easier. Yes. So friends, EPF where I made a comparison of PMGKP scheme and other scheme. तो मतलब यहाँ पे चलो let's try to understand who are eligible under Pradhan Mantri scheme. So that is employees working in firms and having up to 100 workers, of which 90% withdraw not more than 50% month salary. तो ये उनकी बात हो गई जो बहुत छोटे छोटे institutions है, तो वही तो prime area है government ने target किया और cover करने की कोशिश की है. वहाँ पे क्या benefit government दे रहा है, payment of 12% of employer and 12% of employee contribution will be made into EPF accounts by the government. Yes friends, those organizations which has already opted for it, उनके लिए what is the new thing? The new thing is for the month of June, July and August, government has extended their support and now for these 3 months also they will be contributing to your EPF accounts. On the other hand, entities which are not covered in this PMGKP scheme, तो उनके लिए क्या है benefit? तो government ने कहा कि जो जो employees, जहां पे 100 से ज्यादा worker है, या तो फिर वो एम्प्लॉयज जो 15,000 से ज्यादा सैलरी, मतलब बेसिकली ये स्कीम में कवर नहीं होते, उनके लिए गवर्नमेंट ने बोला डोंट वरी, वी आर देयर फॉर यू. व्हाट वी विल ट्राई टू डू इज इन द सिमिलर फैशन ऑफ टीडीएस, यहाँ पे हम आपका कंट्रीब्यूशन रेट घटा देंगे। तो क्या कहा गवर्नमेंट ने कि जहां पे आप 12% एम्प्लॉय कंट्रीब्यूट करता है और 12% एम्प्लॉयर कंट्रीब्यूट करता है, वो रेट अब रिवाइज होके डिक्रीज किया गया है, विच इज अप टू 10%। करेक्ट। तो वो 12% जो अभी तक हर महीने होता था, वो अब आप 10% तक करोगे। अब कौन से पीरियड के लिए करोगे? तो पीरियड हैज बीन डिफाइंड सैलरी फॉर द मंथ ऑफ मे, जून एंड जुलाई। तो दो पार्ट हो गए, एक ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस वो जो गवर्नमेंट की स्कीम में कवर होते हैं, जहां पे गवर्नमेंट एंटायरली इज कंट्रीब्यूटिंग 24% आउट ऑफ देयर पॉकेट टू दो CPF अकाउंट्स, और सेकेंड साइड जो ये एलिजिबिलिटी नॉर्म्स में फॉल नहीं हो रहे, उनके लिए गवर्नमेंट ने बोला कि आप, हम आपको इनडायरेक्टली कंट्रीब्यूट करते हैं, आप 12% की जगह पे 10% पेमेंट करो, बाकी के 2% यू विल बी हैविंग इन कैश। करेक्ट। आगे जो स्मॉल टॉपिक विच इज इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन फॉर मुद्रा शिशु लोन, यहाँ पे मेनली गवर्नमेंट ने ये कहा कि विल बी पेइंग इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन ऑफ 2%। लेट मी टेक यू थ्रू मुद्रा लोन। स्मॉल बिजनेसेस अंडर मुद्रा हैव बीन डिसरप्टेड द मोस्ट बिकॉज दे आर फॉलिंग अंडर द लोअर मिडिल क्लास और मिडिल क्लास बिजनेसेस, एंड the loan moratorium has already been granted by RBI, which many of them would have availed. The current portfolio of mudra shishu loan is 1.62 lakh crores, maximum loan up to 50,000 rupees. The government ne ye kaha ki jo mudra loan shishu loans hai unke andar hum aapko interest subvention denge 2% for those borrowers who are making the prompt payment. Kitne period ke liye denge? To 12 mahine ke liye denge. Correct. So that was about the issue one. अब जो मैंने ये जो अभी तक हमने जो डिस्कस किया, so that was falling within this part, correct? And that was for part one specifically. Now I'll take you through part four, which is very crucial. Why crucial? That I'll explain. So this part 4 aims at growth engine for development of our country. This topic is generic in nature, not specific or not complex, but aap dear participants, aapke liye zaruri hai to see that how promptly government is trying to develop and strengthen their various sectors so that the country becomes self-reliant. So the reason for this discussion of this topic is adoption of new methods for development which government has taken up, the strategic plans for highest contributing sectors, focused on infrastructure development. जो हम सेमिनार के वेबिनार के स्टार्टिंग से बात कर रहे हैं, गवर्नमेंट का पांच पिलर में से मेन पिलर ऑफ वन ऑफ देम इज इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलपमेंट. सो इफ विल आई टेक यू थ्रू दिस वेरियस पॉलिसीज, सो दैट will help you to realize that how government is aggressively working towards increasing the infrastructural development of the country. The beauty of this plan is government is working actively as a private sector. Jaise hum discuss karenge aage, so you will see that it is government or a private sector which is working so aggressively. So friends, as I said, on day 4, government announced new horizons of growth. I have tried to present the broad structure in 4 points. These broad points are related to policy reforms to fast track the investment efforts towards Atmanirbhar Bharat. Yes, friends, at every stage you will see that government ka aim bottom line is only one, Atmanirbhar Bharat. They do not want to promote the foreign market. Their main aim is be vocal for your local products. So friends, first is fast track investment clearance through empowered group of secretaries. This group has been formed. Second, which I see the beauty of this scheme is working jointly, the central and the state government, the project development cell in each ministry to prepare in investable projects, coordinate with investors and central state governments to boost up the development of the projects. Third, very nice, the ranking of the states on investment attractiveness to compete for new investments. Fourth, the incentive scheme for promotion of new champion sector will be launched in sectors such as solar PV manufacturing, advanced cell battery storage, etc. ये भी शायद नेक्स्ट एमएसएमई वाले सेक्टर में कवर करेंगे, जहां पे रिसेंटली नितिन गडकरी जी अलोंग विद प्राइम मिनिस्टर हैज लॉन्च्ड दिस चैंपियन सेक्टर. तो फ्रेंड्स यहां पे देखिए, ये जो चारों पॉइंट्स है आर वेरी यूनिक इन इट्स नेचर एंड एन्यूमरेट्स गवर्नमेंट्स एफर्ट, फर्स्ट बीइंग फॉर्मिंग ऑफ ग्रुप फॉर फास्ट मूवमेंट ऑफ द प्रोसेस, सेकेंड जॉइंट वर्किंग टाइम नॉट्स ऑफ द सेंट्रल एंड द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स टू वर्क विद वेरियस मिनिस्ट्रीज, थर्ड रैंक देंगे ये स्टेट की इन्वेस्टमेंट एट्रेक्टिवनेस पॉलिसी को देख के, विच विल इन टर्न जनरेट अ कॉम्पिटिटिव फीलिंग विद इन स्टेट्स, एंड फोर्थ फॉर्मिंग अ न्यू चैंपियन सेक्टर फॉर द वेरियस स्पेसिफिक सेक्टर्स, जो उनको हेल्प करेगा बूस्ट करने में. नाउ इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ कॉमर्शियल माइनिंग इन कोल. अब ये मेन रिफॉर्म सेकेंड, दिस वॉज द फर्स्ट पार्ट, सेकेंड पार्ट बींग पॉलिसी रिफॉर्म्स. मैंने सिर्फ एक कवर किया है, बाकी के जो है उसे खाली ब्रीफली कवर करूंगा. बट ये एक कवर करने का लॉजिक एंड द रीजन इज कि यू कैन सी हाउ ब्यूटीफुली एंड हाउ स्ट्रेटेजिकली दिस पॉलिसी रिफॉर्म्स हैज बीन ड्राफ्टेड. सो फर्स्ट इज इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ कॉमर्शियल माइनिंग इन कोल. नीड टू रिड्यूस the import of substitutable coal and increase self reliance. Again friends, self reliance in coal production. Government will introduce competition, transparency and private sector participation in the coal sector. Though first revenue sharing mechanism instead of regime of fixed rupee or ton sector. ye jo niche ki outline se jo ab main discuss karunga, these are the changes, policy reforms that has been brought by government to make the mining sector, coal mining sector, an attractive area for the public private partnership model, where government is trying to bring in private sectors in the government areas so that can cope up the fast growth, provide a systematic work. Though there are various pros and cons of it, but right now what is more important is that development of self-reliant India and developing as a developed nation. So let's see friends, what are the 5 points that has been provided. First being revenue sharing mechanism instead of regime of fixed, that is a very good initiative. Second, entry norms will be liberalized. Pehle aisa hota tha ki entry norms hi itne rigid the ki many of the participants were not able to bid, so now that will be liberalized. Third, production earlier than scheduled will be incentivized through rebate in revenue share. See friends, this is also very crucial. Let me elaborate in detail at end. Fourth, infrastructure development of 50,000 crores. A gigantic fund has been provided. Fifth, ease of doing business measures such as mining plan simplification will be taken. ये पांच outlines ऐसी है जो दिखाती है कि हमें एक sense of competition बढ़ाना है. Not only competition, but bringing out utilization of resources in a very positive manner, in an effective manner. So these 4 to 5 factors in the coal sector will now attract more investors, more bidders to take interest in the coal sector and develop it, utilize the resources at its best and make a country self-reliant. Jaise humne ye ek discuss kiya, in the similar fashions there are various other reforms in various sectors. तो उनका मैंने sectors को एक बार list किया है खाली आपके knowledge के लिए. Enhancing private investment in mineral sector. Second, defense production. Third, world class airports through public private partnership model. Fourth, India to become a global hub for aircraft maintenance, repairs and overhaul. Tariff policy reforms will be seen under various sectors. Privatization of distribution in union territories, boosting private sector investment in social infrastructure through revamped viability gap funding scheme, boosting private participation in space activities and atomic energy related reforms. ये सारे reforms को देख के ऐसा लगता है कि government is with a clear motive. Let's walk hand in hand. Don't only run into the model of having centralization model where government will run everything and they will run the show. No, the government's is aim looking at these incentives and schemes seems like these policy reforms will bring in the private participants at a very high speed and will in turn help the country to effective utilization of resources, proper formation of SOPs, definitely increase in the employment and in turn helping the economy. Now, a way forward. Though I am not a career counseling person, but I have tried to frame two or three ideas which I was going through this lockdown phase and watch various webinars. So this was the recent message which I received. As we all know, change is the only constant. Left hand side of the table indicates then the before period, and right hand side the post COVID-19 scenario. People used to say time is money before COVID-19, but now people say life is money. People used to say save water, but on the other end, now people are saying wash your hands for 20 seconds many times a day. Alcohol is bad for health, people used to say, and now they are saying use of sanitizer with 85% of alcohol is recommended. Socializing is good, now they are saying don't be social. Children should stay away from mobiles, parents used to say, and that was the complaint. Now they are saying education should be made online. Traveling is good for health, stay home to live is what they say now. Use public transit to avoid pollution and everything. Now they are saying use your own vehicle. Guest is God, no guesters allowed. So friends, we see a total transformation in the human life which used to be and now it will be. So way forward in the unlock, as we all know, we have shifted from lockdown 4 to unlock 1, where I would suggest that first of all, stay safe. Though government has provided relaxations, but COVID-19 has not. Secondly, stay updated. An essential tool in a phase where every day some new changes are popping up. As we all know, considering this COVID-19 scenario, government is economy is shaking across the globe. So many relaxations as we are having right now this webinar. Stay updated about this kind of knowledge and the reliefs which government has provided. You never know, one of the benefit which you are eligible but that will lapse due to your unawareness. Third, revisit your vision and mission statement so that a new life, era which as we discussed has developed. So if in case if you think that your vision and mission statement is required to be revised considering the new entire working environment, then definitely please have a look at it. These two, fourth and fifth, are my prime areas which I would like to highlight. That is, utilize a digital platform for professionals and especially the youngsters. It is a great opportunity to utilize a digital era where people will now not be more in favor of socializing. And people will be meeting over the online platform, providing services through online platform. So that can also be converted into my point 5, develop new services and products. Evaluate pros and cons, do SWOT analysis. On the basis of that, considering the future prospects and the new market, try to develop and provide new services and products, because the world is dynamic. The environment is dynamic. And if you are not dynamic enough to change with the continuous world, you will be left behind, friends. Say, for example, I would like to give example of our firm. At our firm, during this COVID-19, though work was at a very reduced pace, so what we tried to do, we tried to utilize in framing new products. Say, for example, one being virtual platform. At our firm, we have tried to develop a virtual platform for the services that we can offer. We did a study, we did survey, and came to a final list that these all are the various services or the products that can be provided to our clients through virtual platform, where say for example the benefit of this COVID, which you have realized if you're working from home, no traveling time, a great comfort at work, working from home, sparing family time. So virtual platform has its own benefits. So we tried and analyzed that virtual platform saves a lot of time, helps us to provide services in a better manner. So thereby we tried to explain our clients that if we shift from physical to virtual platform, these are the services and these are the benefits of shifting from physical to virtual. So this will be the key benefits that you will obtain. These are the new era. These are the new products which we can offer you. So that is how we have tried to develop a virtual platform. Secondly, as I've been discussing about MSME, we have framed an MSME department where we tried to analyze and study the government norms. We tried to frame a separate department for it. We tried to set up a separate profile, enumerating the benefits previously, now considering under COVID-19, and what services we as a firm can provide them. So this is just merely an example which I'm quoting to you, that you can also work in the similar fashion to utilize this period and the upcoming days. Further, recently the government, ICAI has been conducting various webinars. So one of the webinar was very interesting about conducting entire accounting industry into a virtual platform, where webinar was of Chad Davis from Canada, who is proprietor of LiveCA, and one firm based at Bangalore, which is working totally through online platform. So when I attended that webinar, I was totally shocked that if the firms outside India or in India can perform these services through an online platform, being in our field, why can't we? Why can't we break the barriers and utilize this opportunity when the economy or the surrounding environment has provided us? So considering these factors, we try to develop those two products. So my urgent request to you all is, you also can utilize this kind of new areas and definitely can grow up with some new services and break the barriers. Reaching to our last topic, that is other updates. So friends, I have bifurcated the updates into two parts. First being regulatory updates, and second, those who are in regular contact would have known that ICAI has been very active during this pandemic period. So first, regulatory update, I tried to cover two areas, one being changes proposed under 269SU, and second, SEBI regulations under the guidelines to be followed by listed companies. We'll consider these two in detail in this second slide. As far as the ICAI guidelines are concerned, there are around five guidelines to the best of my knowledge which has been provided. First being ICAI audit reporting during for the COVID purpose, guidance on inventory during COVID-19, auditing guidance on going concern, ICAI COVID-19 FAQ specifically for Ind AS, and ICAI subsequent event guidance. So all this bucket of guidances which has been provided by the ICAI will be very effective and useful for year-end audits. So please refer it from the ICAI website. That will be very useful. Now, regulatory updates. There were two areas. First being sections 269SU, jahan pe government has came up with a change that businesses need to have their own swiping machine and other 2-3 tools for the purpose of who are falling under the eligibility norms as specified in 269SU, which has now been revised, which states that 269SU shall not be applicable to specified persons having only B2B transactions, and if at least 95% of the aggregate of all the amounts received during the previous year, including the amount received for sales turnover or gross receipts, are by other than cash. Majorly, ये जब January में आया था ये change, तो many of the companies used to not understand why this change has been brought, because using swiping machine, using that QR code, will that be beneficial to us where we are directly dealing into online transactions? So considering that thing, government has came up with this specified eligibility where they have tried to remove the areas, correct? So, but the ultimate goal is to remain in a digital era, to promote digital transactions in the economy. Second being SEBI guidelines, considering the interest of the stakeholders. As you all know, listed companies are supposed to follow SEBI guidelines, LODR guidelines. So where SEBI has came up with a circular that some of the companies have provided the details that we have sanitized our place, and these are the impact, these are the causes. So SEBI tried to frame it in a structured manner. SEBI said that this is the illustrative list which you are supposed to submit to the authorities to SEBI that these are the points, checklist points against which they are supposed to provide the compliance. The circular is available of May 20, 2020. Apart from that, if possible for the companies, they have to mention the financials in their financials, that what are the impact of COVID-19 on their financial statements. So up to an extent, that will help the stakeholders to know that where their company stands post COVID-19. Lastly, I would like to conclude by saying that life is precious, friends. Though restrictions would have been reduced by the government, try to maintain the norms stated by the government and stay safe. Let's try to work hand in hand with the totally changed world where new ways of living and working has been adopted. Thank you so much. I would now request Virag bhai to.
Thank you, Vedant bhai.
Yes,
for
sir.
Wonderful, very informative presentation. One of the participants,
can we take up the question or if there is anything?
Yeah, question we can take. There are a few questions in the question tab.
Yes, yes. Questions.
Okay. What is the limit, lower limit for small enterprise investment?
Sir, can you inform us about the lower limits in investment criteria given under new definition of scheme? So basically, the restrictions which has been provided and the investment and the turnover criteria which has been provided, that are the upper ceilings for small, medium or micro enterprises. So if you have to identify under which category you are falling, based on which the limits which has been prescribed under that category is the highest ceiling. So if you're falling under, say, for example, the medium category, so let me take to that presentation. Say, for example, if you're falling under medium category, so investment in plant and machinery can be up to 50 crores and turnover can be up to 250 crores. So, for example, isme koi lower limit nahi hai, sir. तो आपको ये इन्वेस्टमेंट क्राइटेरिया जो है प्लांट एंड मशीनरी और टर्नओवर का, उसके बेसिस पहले कैटेगरी आइडेंटिफाई करनी है और फिर आपको ये लिमिट चेक करनी है डेफिनेशन के पर्पस से. आर देयर एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस व्हेन आरबीआई विल फ्रेम पॉलिसी फॉर एमएसएमई फॉर 3 lakh crore पैकेज. So basically, that's what I was in discussion with Virag bhai, that MSME being a prime talk of this time, Virag bhai jointly is going to come up with this MSME webinar. Well, we'll be trying to cover what are the key benefits to the MSME sector, because currently it is a premature period. We'll be discussing about the policies when they are not clear. So we are waiting for government to frame appropriate policies based on which various banks will form their policies, and it will be clear on the end of the users as well as the professionals to know what are the actual benefits to be derived from those schemes. So let's wait and hope for the best that it comes as soon as possible. Yeah, we'll definitely share the PPT. Virag bhai will be forming a group of the participants of this webinar, where he or me on my side will be definitely sharing the PPT.
Any other questions?
We are taking one, two more questions.
There is a question that at the date of taking MSME registration, the firm have capital is 40 crore and a month after the firm capital increased to 60 crore. But I think capital is not a criteria in the definition, dear participant. So the criteria basically is for the investments and the turnover. That is done. Another question is, in this ECLGS scheme, only scheduled banks are covered. How borrowers of non-scheduled urban cooperative banks can avail these benefits? So basically, government, jo maine refer kiya RBI circular of 20th of May, that circular of economic package is basically for all the banks, including nationalized cooperative banks. So I suppose it will be included under it. But for exact the scheme which you are specifying about ECLGS scheme, for that we have to refer the circular so as to get the clarity. We can definitely discuss this once the group is formed. Bapna ji, I guess.
We have covered all questions, right?
Yeah, I think majority of them is covered. So for example, the last question is regarding, can you guide in brief about agriculture sector? So basically, considering the time frame as discussed earlier, I have not covered those agriculture, fisheries, that sector, because we have limited time of 1.5 hour, and I guess right. 15 minutes more I consumed.
Yes. So yes. One of the participants want to share her feedback. CA yes, Priyanka Agarwal. Priyanka, you can unmute yourself. Yeah.
I would like to thank CA Vedant Parekh for enlightening us with the various knowledge package of 20 lakh crore package by explaining the various schemes which has come up, the regulatory updates and the recent updates as well. I'm sure this shall help one and all of us in rendering a better service to our clients. How to convert a current situation of COVID-19 into an opportunity is something which you have very well beautifully explained. I will also like to take this opportunity to thank CA Virag Shah, who has always taken efforts to keep the members updated from time to time with all possible knowledge in every field. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Priyanka, for your kind words. Now would like to request our guide TC Bafna sir for formal vote of thanks to CA Vedant K. Parekh.
Okay, thank you, Raj. Thank you, Raj. Yes. It's my great privilege to propose the vote of thanks. Well experienced on banking, audit, finance, and realty sectors, CA Vedant K. Parekh, who is an excellent deliver excellent lectures on the self-reliance package of 20 lakh crore, which are more beneficial for business, MSEB, NBFCs, and industries in a long way to accelerate the economic growth of the country. By announcing this regulatory package, by extending the moratorium for 3 months, by way of rescheduling payments, term loan, working capital, guarantee, credit limit, etc., etc., for the benefit of industries and business in the big way. I thanks again for a most informative and decent on the recent economic package. Thanks again.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you, Virag Bhai and Bapna Ji, for providing me the opportunity and the platform, and kind enough participants for hearing me patiently. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Vedant Bhai. Thank you, all the participants. Thank you for active participation with the question answer also. Now we are ending webinar right away here. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you all.